Hi guys, today I'm gonna show you how to use the F-117 Nighthawk, I mean how to properly use it. But first thing first, I'm gonna show you how to put it in your deck because I'm pretty sure some of you don't know how to do it because it's a prototype and so you need a US deck with bonus to get in your deck. So let me show you how we do that. So go to deck, create, select bonus. NATO, F-117, whatever. National deck, US, and all. So, as you can see, prototype units unlocked. That means you can get your F-117. So, press create. There we go. Go to planes. And you can put your F-117 and you can put two of them maximum in your deck. That's it, pretty much. So let me give you some information about the F-117 Nighthawk before getting this tutorial started. One of the awesome particularity of this jet is its stealth. The F-117 has an exceptional stealth. That doesn't mean it cannot be shot down. It means it's really hard to spot it. The enemy needs powerful radars to be able to see it. So if they have a Buckham 1, for example, next to a target you're going to hit with your Nighthawk, they're going to spot the Nighthawk and engage it and probably kill it because its CCM is really bad. However, they don't have any powerful anti-air systems in the area, they are not going to see a Nighthawk. They are just going to see a massive bomb coming from the skies to their units. Now let's talk about its ECM and the difference between ECM and stealth. The F-117 ECM is bad, there is a reason for it. In reality, when the engineers designed the F-117, they thought that this plane didn't need ECM unit because they assumed it wouldn't be spotted by the enemy entire systems due to its awesome stealth. And they were obviously wrong because an F-117 got shot down over Serbia in 1999 by an SA-3. The stealth is the ability to be invisible and the ECM is the ability to jam entire missiles and avoid them. So the F-117 is kind of invisible unless the enemy has powerful entire system like a Buckham 1. And if they do, you're pretty much screwed because they are most likely going to shoot your F-117 down because of its bad ECM and also because the Buckham 1 is really accurate and deadly. So when you use your F-117, make sure there is no powerful entire systems in the area. Finally, I'm gonna give you some information about its main and only weapon, the GBU-10P3A2. Let's look at its characteristics. Range ground 3500 meters. It means that the F-117 can drop this bomb from 3500 meters away from its target and evacuates immediately just after it drops its bomb. It's a laser guided bomb and it's a fire and forget bomb. That means as soon as the F-117 drops its bomb, it's just gonna follow the target if the target's moving and it's gonna hit the target with a deadly accuracy. It's unbelievable. Look at its accuracy 8, but trust me, it's way more accurate than that. I mean, it never miss, really. It's you'll see that in my videos. HE power 28. That means it's extremely effective against infantry, really. It's a huge bomb. Suppression 1500, that means it stuns even heavy tanks and shit like that. Even if it doesn't kill tanks, heavy tanks I mean, heavy units, that stuns them. So if the enemy is rushing you with like a shit ton of tanks and you just drop these bombs on them, they're gonna be stunned, like really stunned, and they ain't gonna move. You're gonna be stuck where they are. And yeah, this bomb can kill infantry and light tanks like, I don't know, scorpions or shit like that. And the rate of fire, 6 rate per minute, doesn't really mean shit, because, oh no, it only has one bomb, so yeah, as soon as it drops the bomb, it evacuates, so.
This is how big a GBU-10 is. It's a 2,000 pound unpowered guided bomb. It's deadly accurate. Now let's get the party started. So I always use my F-117 Nighthawks as CV killers, command vehicles killers. So I use recon infantry to, you know, spot their CVs in their flags and send my Nighthawks to, you know, go all around the map, sneak in their base, and drop their GBU-10 on the CV. So that's precisely what I'm doing right now. Oh, there's a Tunguska right there. I'm just gonna put my F-117 over there so they don't get shot. And you always have to, you know, look at the fuel tank. Just, you know, on the bottom, you can see the GBU-10 Power V2, and on the left, you can see the name of the pilot and the fuel. So right now I have 800 on 2000 fuel. Oh, someone's lagging. Okay. So, you know, as you can see, I'm almost out of fuel. I'm gonna do it. I see it. Yeah, I'm gonna do it. Yeah, out of fuel. Out of fuel. Drop your bomb. Drop your bomb. Nice. And bombs our way. Hit. And hit. CV in their base is down. You can also use your Nighthawks to completely destroy the enemy defense line before attacking their flag. And to do that, you need to keep using recon units, in this case recon infantry. You also have to use your brain to guess where the CV and their units might be, and also another jet to defend your Nighthawks against enemy jets and entire units, just like this.
And golf.
Don't care.
Where do you need us, sir? We're sweeping this area.
You can also attack the enemy short range entire units. They won't even be able to see your Nighthawk, so use it to take them out, and then send other jets or helicopters to take out their tanks and other units.
I'm gonna take out this treadhouse with Nighthawk.
Do it, please.
Air defense ready.
Nighthawk in bail.
You can also use your Nighthawk when you are being rushed by a shit ton of tanks and stun them all.
keep using your Nighthawk against enemy CVs if you're sure there is no good AAs around.
Wow, my fucking Chaparral wasted all of its missiles on a fucking Raven. Or an SC-24.
Medical is mine.
No, fuck you!
Same as Medicus.
Boom!
What?
Fire artists kill all the infantry.
You can also use your Nighthawks against enemy units, even if they are still entire units. Use an anti-radar plane first, like a Raven or Polar, so the enemy AAs shoot at him and not at the Nighthawks. And don't worry about your seed plane, it will survive thanks to its exceptional ECM.
Ah, she got this.
You guys got those mortars?
Yeah, I did.
Nice, man. That's what's killing us.
You can also hit moving targets with the F-117 because its GBU-10 is laser guided, so it follows its target. Don't press for position, but select the Nighthawk and right click on the moving unit you want to destroy, and the bomb will do the rest, just like this.
This PRDM is gonna get wrecked. Bomb's away. The PRDM's moving. And the bomb's following him. He's our miss and bomb.
Time for a bonus video.
Waking up to ash and dust, I wipe my brow and I sweat my rust. I'm breathing in the chemicals.
Hey guys, thank you for watching this video, and please leave a